guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 7 of My Senpai is Annoying, so let's go ahead and get started, and 3, 2, 1, go. I still wish I got something to drink. It's okay, I'll get it after. Sports day? Sports day. No! We about to see Baby Futaba today again. Are you fucking kidding me? See, this is why I don't always like children. It's not cool. There should be something for him. Because he tripped her. We all saw that ish. You know if it was freaking, I'm about to say Bunny Girl Senpai. Wrong show. oh, God. I can't. If it was freaking, Kobayashi-san, and it was Kana, you know Kobayashi be like, hold up! That child clearly kicked Kana. She tripped Kana. Get her out! You know Kobayashi be like, hey yo, get that child. Me when I have a child, because if I see something, be like, right there, get that kid. But that is fucked up. I hope she's not so mad about that even now. I mean, that would be weird. Do not take, like, a grudge as a little kid for, like, the longest time and still be mad about that as an adult. Please don't. I still want to know who his seiyuu is so bad. I think, you know what? After I'm done watching this episode, we're going to find out. It looks so much better than a Pop-Tart because I had a pumpkin pie Pop-Tart. It was good, but that looks even better. Really? Flashback. Is your Wi-Fi on? I mean, not even your Wi-Fi. Is your cellular data on? I guess so. Mm-hmm. That is literally me and my friends. Like, me, tall as fuck. My friends, short as fuck. Oh, you poor baby. Yeah, them short little legs. God. Okay, so hold on. If you 12? Well, you know what? When I was 12, I looked like that too. And people thought I was like 16. Hell, even 20. God, I really love her eyes. I know. Like a kitten. This ain't school, though. We skipping. You know what? Let me go ahead and ask that question, because I think here, I don't remember what happens when people get in trouble here, but like, yeah, what the heck really happens if like kids ditch Japan at school? I mean, because you know, I only got like my little experience from Persona 5-ish. This thing Komi saw make me fangirl way too much. Yeah, basically. Training. Oh my god, me too, Yuta.
Me too. Oh my god, we've been late, buddy.
Unfortunately for me, I don't like to run because I have asthma. So, that's not the greatest thing in the world. Yeah. She's right. Well, I mean, you have that too, but your legs, you know, most of us tall folk, we're supposed to be in a sport. Trust me. A girl was in basketball, and then I did volleyball. And then I did golfing, but you know, that's anybody type height. Sport. Yeah. I'm gonna die. No. Oh, that looks good. Is that corn dogs? I haven't had a corn dog in like, well, no, I've had the mini ones, and that was like a couple of months ago, which were good, but like, if we're talking about a vodka, yes! If we're talking about like an actual corn dog and a stick, ooh, it's been forever.
Tequila.
Just make sure if you get really drunk, you know, you got a buddy system. Really? Thank you. Remember, he's been to your room. Really, your house. But not in that notebook. She's so freaking cold. Like, oh my god, I can't. Yes, punch that bastard again. Oh, you're apologizing? Oh, well, good for you. Yeah, but you. Yeah, you know. Yeah. Please don't. We don't need you to get in trouble. No. I ship it. Mm-hmm. Oh, baby. Track and field. Because she likes running. Oh, that precious smile. This is literally the week of precious smiles. Everybody, it's either the precious smiles or precious smiles and crying, and it's just like, bruh. No, I can't. Mm-hmm. It's time to go home. That was cute. Oh my god. Like, number one, to have an episode that literally focused on Futaba and Natsumi's, you know, past and how they met and everything was really, really interesting. Makes you wonder if, you know, her senpai is gonna get a past flashback type episode in the next few weeks, but because of the fact is he is not the main, protagonist of the show. He's like the secondary. Of course, he's not gonna get that. He gets moments, and I love that, but like, still. But yeah, I ship it. I mean, any moment when Natsumi and Futaba just give you, like, shippable moments, even though I'm already shipping Futaba with, you know, her senpai, because they just look so cute together, and I can't, and such. But I mean, yeah, this is a very, like, good episode. I mean, to see how, you know, in the beginning Natsumi was, you know, at sports day, she gets tripped by a kid, and because of that, you know, it traumatized her into wanting to run again. But, you know, you have our lovely protagonist Futaba coming in to save the day and such. I mean, how, this is so good. Once again, with all the smiles, because, oh my god, y'all literally had the two children smile today and was just like, hey, sunshine, pure sunshine. Like, oh, I can't. That's good. You rubbed off on him. Aww. One more precious smile for the end of the episode. Oh my god. It's so fucking cute. Hell, even, you know, everyone going out to see the cherry blossoms was very interesting and adorable as well. I mean, hell, that is a day off, essentially. You get to enjoy, like, nature at its finest. I mean, that's, like, I'll never forget the time. This kind of happened to me at school one time. I think this was, like, sixth grade. We decided to go on this, like, kind of walk thing. We went to the neighborhood that is, like, right behind our school and everything, and it's like that. And we went on this, like, picnic or just, like, lunchtime thing where we were, like, just chilling and everything and such. And so you got to, in Nebraska at the time and where I lived, I mean, it was beautiful. You had greenery, but, I've always, like, anytime if I've ever wanted to go on, like, a lunch date, especially in the park or somewhere, I wanted to be somewhere that's nice and pretty, you know, flowers everywhere. Never personally got that, you know? But one day, I will get that, and I will be oh so happy, hopefully, if I ever go to Japan one day, because that is the dream. But, I mean, it was sweet, and the fact that, you know, Futaba was able to tell her senpai a little bit more about, you know, not only her backstory, but Natsumi's backstory, which is adorable. I mean, anything with a flashback in an episode to me is really good because we get to learn more about said characters. And that's the one thing that I love about, you know, any anime in a nutshell, is learning more about the characters and seeing what their hopes, their dreams, their passions, anything else in between that they care about for, and what they were also like when they were teenagers and stuff. Like, the fact is that Futaba is older than Natsumi. Like I said, I could see now, you know, looking at her, I'm like, okay, so you 12? I'm like, okay, but like, yeah, that's me in a nutshell, because like I said, when I was 12, I was like 5, I'm 6 foot now, but like, at the time when I was 12, I was like 5-something, and I've told this story like a lot, and I love telling this story. So my parents and I went to this theme park in Nebraska. I don't remember what the name of it was called. And so they normally have like a moment where like, here's all the theme parks and everything. And then here is like where all the other carnival type things are and everything, the attractions and stuff. So we were just walking around and this guy was at the stand where it says like, get your age or get your height, and such. Right. And so my parents were like, oh, okay, we about to like go in on this. So, we walk up and he asks us, okay, whose age am I guessing? And so my parents point to me and such. And so he gets like a good look at me and such. And so I was either 12 or 13 at the time, cause I was in middle school. And like I said, got a good little look at me. And so he started saying like, 14, 15, 16, 18. And I'm looking at this dude like, no. And so when I told him my actual age, he was like, what the and it's even always been like that. Ever since, you know, when I lived in Nebraska for 6 years and I met someone who initially saw my heightness and they were like, oh, okay, you should play basketball, you should play volleyball and stuff. And I'm like, like, I hated basketball. I really, truly did. I loved volleyball, but just, and then golfing. Here, coming back to Florida and doing golfing for, like, my semi-final year of high school. I mean, it was interesting. I only did it because of Wii Sports, that's it. But it was interesting. that was my junior year. Towards, like, the end of my junior year, I started to like it, but I just didn't want to do it anymore. I was just like, I'm over it. So it took us almost, like, a whole year for me to give the golf clubs my biggest goal. Teacher kept changing throughout the damn year. But yeah, other than that, guys, that is my reaction to you towards episode 7 of My Senpai is Annoying. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like, it really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel, I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad, and of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for episode 8. Bye, guys.